بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My beloved brothers and sisters, in order to do anything, you require energy. Where does that energy come from? One might say the energy comes from the food and drink, the nutrients that I partake of, what I consume. That is correct. Now, did you realize that your body and your system is energized to do good things when your consumption is of halal and pure food? And your body and your system is energized to do the wrong things when there is something wrong with what you consume. Now, that is extremely important. It puts into perspective a lot. We have a narration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wherein he speaks of a man who is raising his hands, crying to Allah, calling out for his needs. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that what is said about this man is, مَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامُ وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامُ وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامُ فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لِذَلِكَ. His food is haram, his drink is haram, his dress is haram, everything is haram. غُذِّيَ بِالْحَرَامُ. His entire system has been nourished by what is haram. How is this person's dua going to be answered? Now, if you look at the verses we recited tonight of Surah Al-An'am and Surah Al-A'raf thereafter, in Surah Al-An'am, Allah says very clearly,
فَكُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكِرَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ إِن كُنتُم بِآيَاتِهِ مُؤْمِنِينَ.
If you are true believers, eat from that which the name of Allah is mentioned upon. We as Muslims are not allowed to just kill an animal and begin to consume. You have to seek the permission of the giver of the life to have taken that life away for a purpose, and the means of taking the life away should be the most humane manner. May Allah grant us an understanding. More than that, we are supposed to be looking at how that animal was treated during its life, especially when we have nowadays the commercial growth of these particular birds or animals. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us success and an understanding. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us very clearly not to consume that where the name of Allah has not been mentioned upon its slaughter. So if there is an animal and it has just been killed, you're not allowed to consume that because it has been literally stolen from the property of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us an understanding.
وَلَا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا لَمْ يُذْكَرِ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِسْقَ.
Don't consume that where the name of Allah has not been mentioned upon its slaughter, because it is sinful and it is impure. We must make sure that even the income we have needs to be from a permissible source, from a pure source. Don't steal and deceive from people. Don't con the people, because as much as you may have amassed wealth, but the energy you derive from that will never be used in the right direction. If you are feeling lazy to fulfill your duty unto Allah and you're feeling energized to commit sin, it's about time you asked yourself a question: where is my income coming from? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. I move on to something very interesting also at the end of Surah Al-An'am, where Allah speaks about good deeds and the fact that Allah is just. He does not hold against you a bad deed except as one bad deed. But when it comes to good deeds, He multiplies it for you if you looked after it. We did Salah just now. We heard the most beautiful recital of Sheikh Mustafa Zain. Beautiful recital. Literally, it took us amazingly into these verses, and I'm sure every one of us felt the same. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us these good deeds that you do for the sake of Allah, yes, they are recorded next to your name. If you arrive on the day of judgment and you have your good deed with you and you did not give it to someone because of backbiting, stealing, cheating, deceiving, etc., when you have taken from the rights of others, you are going to pay these good deeds to them. So you won't have it when you come. It's going to be taken away from you. But if you have protected yourself from harming others in any way, and you bring your good deed on the day of judgment, listen to what Allah says.
من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها.
Whoever comes with a good deed on that day, it shall be multiplied for them by 10. And when you come with a bad deed, Allah says, we don't multiply bad deeds. We look for any excuse to forgive that bad deed.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ.
Besides shirk and association of partnership with Allah in worship, Allah says, I can forgive anything. If you come without having sought the forgiveness, one thing I don't want to forgive. The rest of the things, who knows? I may choose to forgive you. May Allah grant us from His mercy. So remember to look after your good deeds by being good to others, no matter who they are. Don't transgress. No need to say bad words about others behind their backs. Say a good word. What are you losing or gaining, subhanAllah, when you say something bad? In fact, when you say something bad, you lose a lot. But when you are saying something good, you will only but gain. May Allah subhanahu, you will only gain. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. If we look at the next surah that we recited this evening, moving on to Surah Al-A'raf, two very distinct matters that I want to make mention of, connected to a certain extent. The first is the creation of the first of our species. Who was he? Adam alayhi salam. Something you need to think about is Adam alayhi salam was created by Allah. He spoke to Allah. Allah addressed him. Allah told him, you can do what you want in this place. That place was a garden. It was a unique garden. The scholars have said it's not the same garden that is called Jannatul Firdaus, but it is a different type of a Jannah which was created specially for that particular purpose. So everything was allowed there, permissible. Everything is okay. You can do whatever you want, besides one thing. Think about this. Allah told him, do anything and everything. Eat anything and everything. You can do what you like, you and your spouse.
وَلَا تَقْرَبَا هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةَ فَتَكُونَا مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ.
Don't consume from one tree. Only this tree, don't eat from it. One thing. Can you imagine that is exactly the same tree that he ate from? Allahu Akbar. Can you think of this? Allah told him not to do one thing, and that is exactly what he did. If Adam alayhi salatu was salam fell to the trap of shaitan, do you really think you and I are going to be strong enough not to fall into his trap? But Allah's mercy will protect us. Our dedication by the help of Allah, for the sake of Allah, will protect us. The good thing is, as soon as he ate, he knew he did wrong, he regretted. As soon as you and I commit sin, we should know we did wrong and we should regret. A sign of goodness and your iman is that you regret the sin you committed. Then immediately he said a few good words to Allah. What were those words? We mentioned them before, we recited them tonight.
رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ.
Oh Allah, we wronged ourselves. And if you don't forgive us and you don't have mercy on us, we are going to be the losers. Allah says, you know what? I forgive you. Subhanallah. From this I learned that there is hope for you and I to earn Jannatul Firdaus by constantly turning to Allah wherever shaitan has trapped us. Now, that we've learnt. Allah says when a person commits sin, what happens? They become shameless. If you remain in the sin, there comes a time when you no longer regret it. The first time you do something wrong, say pornography, say for example adultery, or say drugs, whatever else it might be. First time you do it, you feel guilty. You feel like, oh, this is something terrible. I shouldn't have done this. That's a sign of your flicker of iman. The angel is trying to help you, to tell you not to do this. If you do it again and again and again and again, they say a person becomes so used to it that it's second nature. They no longer think it's haram. When you delay your salah, you don't do your salah. You missed one salah, you are like qiyamah has come. What just happened? But you start missing it every other day. There comes a time when you don't bat an eyelid. To you, it's okay, I'll sleep. You don't even think I should wake up for my prayer for the sake of Allah. It might just be my last prayer before I die. Subhanallah. So that is a point of advice that Allah gives us, an instruction not to fall in the trap of shaitan in the same way that shaitan trapped our father Adam, may peace be upon him. And the last thing I wish to mention today is probably one of the most touching verses when it comes to a discussion between the people of Jannah, paradise, and the people of hellfire. And we've spoken about this year in, year out, because it is definitely something true. Allah uses the past tense because for Him, it's as good as done. Subhanallah. Remember, tenses and time is a creature of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy what is known as time. How? Allah knows best. But listen to the discussion.
وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ أَنْ قَدْ وَجَدْنَا مَا وَعَدَنَا رَبُّنَا حَقًّا.
The people of paradise will call out to the people of hellfire, "Hey, we found what we were promised by Allah to be true."
فَهَلْ وَجَدْتُمْ مَا وَعَدَ رَبُّكُمْ حَقًّا.
So did you find what Allah promised you to be true as well? And you know what that means, right? Allah promised us you do good, you get good. And you do bad, what will happen? You obviously cannot be recompensed with goodness when you do bad. So the people of hellfire, Allah says,
قَانُوا نَعَمْ.
They will say, yes, indeed. In regret, in shame, they will say, yes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has registered that discussion because it is going to happen. And there will come a time, Allah says, when those of hellfire will be burning such that they will call out to those in paradise. May Allah make us from among those in paradise. Say ameen. Ask Allah every day, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah. Ask Allah every day, ask Him. It is registered when you say, don't forget to ask Allah, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannata wa ma qarraba ilayha min qawlin wa amal, aw amal. Oh Allah, I ask You paradise and I ask You to make easy for me to do those deeds that will bring me closer to Jannah and even the utterances that will bring me closer to Jannah. So listen to this discussion.
وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهِ.
They will say, the people of hellfire will say to those of paradise, can you please pour on us a little bit of water or anything that you can grant us on this day from what Allah has given you? That's the discussion. Because of the heat, pour on us a little bit of water, any liquid, throw it in this direction so that we can at least have a little bit of, you know, the lessing of the burden and the feeling of this punishment.
قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَهُمَا عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَهْوًا وَلَعِبًا وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا.
The people of Jannah and Paradise will say, you know what? Allah has prohibited it today from those who disbelieved, those who did not take their religion seriously, those who did not take their connection with Allah seriously. They thought it was just an amusement and pastime and they forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they just played on earth. They amused themselves and that's it. They didn't prepare for this day. Yet they were warned again and again. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا.
On this day, we will forget them. In the same way, they forgot their day that they were going to meet with us this day. They forgot it. So what we will do, we'll forget them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us from His mercy. All these warnings in the Quran are there in order for us to be correcting ourselves so that we can do the right thing, inshallah. The warnings in the Quran of the punishment are there in order to make us do the right thing and to let us know that indeed goodness awaits those who do good. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us from His goodness and may Allah open our doors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of Jannatul Firdaus and Paradise. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.